I'm David Bohnert with Oregon State University, and I'm the director of the Eastern Oregon Agricultural Research Center, which is comprised of the Burns and Union Station. A large focus of the research I do out here is beef cattle nutrition and management, especially as it relates to rangelands. Throughout the last 3 years, we have conducted a handful of different studies investigating the potential applications of virtual fencing as a land management tool. This technology has advanced to the point where it allows us to have a lot of flexibility in managing our working lands based on specific objectives. Today, I'm going to discuss how virtual fencing can potentially be used to meet both wildlife management and cattle production objectives within pastures containing riparian areas. Out here in northeastern Oregon, one of the primary management concerns is the degradation of salmonid-bearing streams. Because some of these fish are protected under the Endangered Species Act, land managers are required to ensure that these riparian systems aren't being degraded by other land utilization practices. Land managers often monitor the health of these systems using a protocol known as Multiple Indicator Monitoring, or MIM. When assessing the impacts of grazing on this critical fish habitat, there are three primary indicators of consequence: bank alteration, stubble height, and shrub utilization. If within-season monitoring shows that one or more of these indicators of riparian health have exceeded certain thresholds, then a grazing permittee is often required to remove their cattle from the entire riparian pasture. Consequently, grazing within these resource-rich pastures is typically very restricted in both duration and seasonality. Some permittees will temporarily install traditional fencing around riparian areas so they are better able to fully utilize these valuable pastures. However, the costs, time, and labor involved often make this not a viable option. Our objectives are to utilize virtual fence technology to mitigate the potential impacts of grazing on critical fish habitat during sensitive time periods while extending utilization opportunities and increasing flexibility to permittees. Currently, we are running a 2-year experiment investigating the effectiveness of this application. Although we have already found through other studies that virtual fencing can be extremely effective in controlling animal distribution, there are a lot of variables to be investigated. The required level of effectiveness of the technology is highly dependent on the application-specific management objectives. Although we are not anticipating 100% exclusion of grazing from riparian areas, which rarely occurs even with traditional fencing, we are hoping it will give us an acceptable level of control over the grazing behavior of the herd. Even if 20% of the herd still ends up in the riparian area, that's a huge benefit over 80 to 100%. And what would this allow for land managers and permittees? Well, it could potentially extend the amount of time permittees can graze that pasture, or given the same amount of time to graze, significantly reduce the degradation of that riparian area.